So this is where we were at the end of the last tutorial. I've just gone back and shown everything, just so everything's in there at the moment. As you can see, if we go onto the head controller there, those are the blend shapes that we put in last time. We can run them all together if we need to. So they're in the rig. And really, at the moment, all we need to do is go show none. We need to see polygons, we need to see the joints, because those are the things that we're going to be making work together. Hit 4, so we can see it as a wireframe. What we need to do is make the mesh, which is now the skin, follow the joint system. So what we're going to do is, again, we're going to go into rigging. So go to the rigging menu. We're on the rigging shelf, so that's fine. We need to find the root joint. Now, the root joint, I do believe, there. Right, so that's in the middle. So that's top of the hierarchy. So if we go anywhere else, we're only going to go down the hierarchy. And if we go there, we'll go down the hierarchy. But if we get that joint there, the root, then we've got the whole hierarchy. Then, skinning, or the skin modifier, is a that constraint? No, it's a deformer. But it's there. So fine skin. So in the same way as it would be a constraint, we're gonna go shift select the mesh, go skin, bind skin. Now there's all sorts of different things. We can unbind skin there, and we can do paint skin weights is what we're going to end up doing. Interactive bind skin is a quick way. It uses default volumes for describing influences. But this guy is a bit of a weird shape, so I think I'm going to go for the traditional bind skin. Open the dialog box. And so we need to bind to the joint hierarchy. There are options to select joints and object hierarchy and things like that, but joint hierarchy is what we want. Blend shape closest distance. Skinning method. I'm going to go for weight blended. So classic linear is the basic way of doing it. Dual quaternion stops collapsing in joint in elbows and things like that. Weight blended sort of mixes the two together, so that's good. Weight distribution distance, so how far away it is from the joint. Allow multiple bind poses. Maximum influences. Well, normally I think that no, any sort of vertex only really needs to be affected by no more than three joints. So like the one above it, the one below it, and the one in the middle. So we could do that. We could call it 4 just in case we've got some, we've got some vertices here that might want to be pulled around by the spine and maybe some of the thing. But I mean, it's a bit of experimentation. Drop off rate 4, da da da. Bind skin. So now, if we just go curves, 5, maybe 6, there you go. Let's just see what we get. So I'm going to go, this guy's orientation only, rotate. So, oop, we've got that. There's your head. Shrug, yep, there you go. Shrug once the head's moved. 0 for now again. Everything above there should follow that. There we go. Not too bad. Third. If we Q select that guy, shift select all these controllers, we should be able to then crazily drive that entire curve together. That's cool. Zero them all out again. Oops. Wiggle. Waist. Move up and down. Let's have a look at a foot. Now, you can now see that in moving this board, some of these joints are now influencing up into the cushion and downside here. Now we don't really want that, so we don't want, as we move this guy around, to influence the side of the cushion. As he turns up, we don't want that pushing back in. We do the Y distance and put him back on the ground. We can just have a look at toe control. Well, that's not too bad. Heel control. And again, it's mainly because it's driving these joints up and they're influencing that. The actual foot itself doesn't look too bad. And if we rotate him up by the heel, see, that looks fine as well. But mainly, I think it's mainly that joint. So we'll just have to see what's making those influences go weird. Right. So let's have a look at skin weighting. Let's check what other ones have got issues. Okay, again, it's the same thing again. And then this guy, yeah, he's influencing up into the back of the chair there, and around that there. And that's probably because, you know, this joint is probably closer to that than this joint up here. But really, we want this section here to follow that joint, and we want this section here to follow that joint, because, you know, when we wiggle at the moment, it doesn't look too bad because these joints are following that one, and so these vertexes, but there's just a little bit too much deformation there. Right, zero. So we've now identified areas that we want to work on. So skin. Select the thing that we want to paint weights on. Skin. Paint skin weights. So, again, the tool settings are contextual, so we get this. In fact, we can want to do my usual thing, which is dock it down the side here. So I'm starting to build up a bunch of tabs, shape, editor, and tool settings are down here, just while I'm kind of working on this guy. And so, root there. Doesn't have that much of an influence. Pelvis is there. The pelvis, we probably want to influence the top of the legs a little bit less, but here more. So we've got ways of painting things there. So it's a paint modifier. So you can use this with your Cintiq pen if you want, and actually do use it as a brush tool. I can use it both ways really. So if we go paint, replace, so replace with the value of 1, and so we go pelvis, so anything that we want to follow the pelvis completely, we can do that here. And again, like the skeleton, you only have to do it one side because you've got a skin weight mirroring facility on this. So I'm going to say follow pelvis. And on that leg over there, go back again. This one wants to follow the pelvis. B, alter the size of the brush. And really, you're painting the value onto the vertices of the base mesh. So there are tricks that if you're using multiple meshes like this, but they've actually been combined, you can always go back to select, go face, and then just select any face and go shift greater than, and just select the whole thing like that. Haha. Everything? That's everything. And then just go show, isolate, select, view selected. You know, and then go back to paint skin weights, and you're still on pelvis, see all of this guy and you can kind of work on him. Say, I know this is what I want. Valuable. Actually, you need to go back to object mode, there we go. Object mode, select object, paint skin, oops, there we go, that's better. Now it will work. So we've got that, and then the same is true if you go show. I select, take it off again, and you kind of go, I want to get inside the frame. It's the same thing, it's select face. Go shift greater than. So you've just got the frame, right? Show, isolate, select, view selected, and then you've got to have it selected as an object, and then you go back and paint weights again. And so if you want to get inside this frame, this is good if you've got kind of like joints driving eyes and eyeballs, you know, you combine them in with the rest of the model just for convenience sake, you can actually sort of like weight them separately. Like this, even though they're still they're actually part of the same combined surface. Right, okay. So we've now told this that it's got to follow. We're going to not worry about the other side. We're going to do this leg. So back hip joint. So we've got this is back hip joint. You can see that the back hip joint is influencing. Into the frame, or did though, we're going to mirror it across, it doesn't matter. So maybe what we want to do is kind of go actually, these ones we want to make sure that their back hip joint drives that bit of the leg a little bit more. Okay, and then knee joint. A little bit more like that. That looks about right, and then the ankle joint. On the heel there. Heel joint, toe joint. Yeah, there. Put a little bit of weight on the heel joint. Down. Toe joint and toe. That looks like it will work okay. So left hip joint. Now, not influence out. Let's we do a value of 0. We can tell it not to influence that at all. So we can paint a value of 0 in, which is sometimes handy. And then hip joint. So we can tell the hip joint to the value of 1. 3. Area just that little bit more. And then knee joint just a little bit more in here. Ankle joint is good, but one bit more maybe. There-ish. But also we've got that heel joint as well, which we might want to say actually no, not the heel joint. A little bit too much there. Ankle joint's good. And then toe joint and toe end. Right. So show I select you selected. Let's just have a look and select and move. I get this guy now and pick him up. See, the leg is working now. Now, pulling too much on the cushion, but it is still. Let's see, something's pulling on the cushion. So, what we need to do is kind of go, well, this area of the cushion here, let's just go back to. Joints out for now. Oh, actually, I'll take the nibs curves out as well. see the left hip joint is perhaps influencing up there, so value 0. B to make the brush a bit bigger. Let's paint that out. Joint influencing torso, show those curves, select one. Yeah, you see, because that's now isolated that from that. That's looking okay. Those deformations in the hip there are okay. Probably a bit too much there, so select that. Yeah, you can see it's got a influence there, value 0. Looks good. Let's go back here and zero this out. And then just check the other bits of those controllers. That's good. This one's good, that works. Nice. Let's just double check. Having messed with those. So that guy somewhere up there is pushing down into the frame on that side. This is the frame that we sorted this side of the model out. So it's not too bad on this side. And then it's gonna be fine. So if you've got, it's not sort of like blending out nicely, you can always go in here and then kind of go, this is like spine one or two, so tool settings, spine one, two. You can go smooth and then you can make the brush a bit bigger and you can smooth out the joints on the implants, so spine one. Just try and sort of blend them a little bit more, especially if they don't seem to be level across the character. 1, 3. Head. I wonder if head needs just a little bit more weight on it there. Just see what that looks like. I think that looks quite nice. That works quite well. Got quite a good blend. Because it is a chair back, it's not a head, so he can sort of like look around if he wants to. Cool. And we know he can shrug. Because that is there. Cool. So I think, apart from moving stuff across, let's see then, we get this guy, and we go skin, mirror skin weights, we want the plane is YZ, yep, closest joint, positive, we've done it on the side, over to negative, or positive X to negative X, apply, close. So now, hopefully, go back to this guy, you can see how we fixed it on that side, now fixed on the other side as well. And this works for bipeds with arms and fingers and stuff like that. It will transfer those weights to the closest joint on the other side that makes most sense. Don't know how it does it, but it does it very well. And that is the skin weighting done on the character. So all we've got left to do now is animate him. So that's the next one. I'll see you in that final tutorial.